Happening today on the stage, Duke City Repertory Theater is kicking off their season with an all-new take on a classic of American cinema. Just in time for Halloween, they are bringing to the stage their adaptation of one of the most beloved and revolutionary works of horror.
What is scary about zombies is not really the zombies themselves, but rather the complete devolution of humanity and society.
It was a revolution of horror cinema in 1969.
They're coming to get you, Barbara.
A group of rogue filmmakers, led by an unknown writer-director named George A. Romero, produced a low-budget independent feature called Night of the Living Dead.
Whenever you say Night of the Living Dead, people will always, it's to me a positive response every single time. People are like, oh, that's still really good to watch, or that was such a great original.
The first time I ever watched this movie, I watched it with my older cousin, and he fell asleep on me. And I remember I literally couldn't move the whole night. I had to go to the bathroom so bad. And then I ran to the bathroom real quick and then ran back to the couch.
The granddaddy of all zombie movies is getting a fresh coat of guts from the talents at Duke City Repertory Theater.
I wanted to do an adaptation of Night of the Living Dead because it's the quintessential zombie film. It's the first zombie that's ever existed. And I thought it would be such an interesting challenge to try to create. You always hear of these adaptations of the film for stage, and there's like a musical or something like that, and they never seem to work out very well.
Writer Josh Hurd, along with director Amelia Empuera, were intent on bringing the horror of the original to the stage without the camp.
I really wanted to find a way to continue the energy of the crazy stuff that's happening and not break it into scenes. So the first solution was, well, why not see if the whole thing can take place in the basement?
How long have you guys been down there? I could use some help up here.
That's the cellar. It's the safest place.
The zombies are obviously a problem, but the bigger problem is how these individuals deal with the situation. And if we introduce this idea of upstairs versus downstairs from the very, very first moment, then we get to struggle with the human problems from the get-go.
The ensemble is comprised of Duke City Rep Company members, as well as guest artists. Among the stars is DCRT vet Frank Green, who takes on the iconic role of Ben, a role that unintentionally helped pave the way for African-American actors in American cinema.
I want to avoid trying to make a statement that they were not trying to make, but yet at the same time, I feel like it is very important that you see a representation of a black man that is not the easy thing to do. He's not a pimp, he's not a thug, he's not illiterate. It is a man in a situation, happens to be black, but other than that, he is no different than the other four people that are in the basement trying to live, trying to survive.
Oh, Jesus.
DCRT's production of Night of the Living Dead from the basement not only aims to push the theatrical envelope of live performance, it has the opportunity to reflect the discord of America today, which is still dealing with similar problems when the film was made more than 40 years ago.
There's so many things happening with in our communities where there's just this unnecessary violence, and if we can find more tools to listen and then create preventative measures, like how can we actually prevent some of this violence that's happening in our communities?
For more information on Duke City Repertory's production of Night of the Living Dead from the basement, head over to foxnewmexico.com.
And Night of the Living Dead runs October 13th through the 23rd at 316 Central in East Downtown. There will be two shows per evening as the runtime is under an hour, but be sure to book your tickets soon as seating is limited.